Each year in November, the global community paints itself orange, answering the call to action to stand in solidarity with victims and survivors of gender-based violence around the world. The Unite to End Violence campaign against women and girls campaign is a more recent initiative, but it is a part of the wider 16 Days of Activism against gender-based violence campaign. The 16 Days of Activism campaign was initiated in 1991 and starts on November 25th, which is the International Day to Eliminate Violence Against Women, and end on the 10th December, International Human Rights Day. This 3 week period provides an opportunity for government agencies, NGOs, the private sector, networks, and individuals who focus on gender-based violence to combine efforts to increase awareness about this grave human rights violation. In Belize, the campaign seeks to galvanize support in an effort to raise awareness and collective action to end gender-based violence. This year's theme, From Awareness to Accountability, Unmasking the Many Faces of Violence, attempt to expand the conversation and the focus from only victims to everyone and everything that contributes and perpetrates violence within our homes, schools, communities, and workplaces. The team invites everyone to play a role in the fight against gender-based violence, and there is no disputing that our Joel is not immune from violence in its many forms. There have been 109 murders so far this year. 89 cases of sexual crime have been reported since the beginning of 2019. The reported cases of domestic violence have surpassed 2,000 for the past 3 years. Added to these are incidents of other forms of child abuse, elder abuse, cyberbullying, and other forms of violence which continue to disintegrate the fabric of our society. This year's theme challenges us all to personally reflect on ways we have actively or unwittingly promoted violence. Have we, through word or deed or inaction, fostered the negative values, behaviors, attitude, and opinion which lead to discrimination, judgment, and ultimately violence? The root causes of gender-based violence are deeply planted in our society, and we all must be advocating our own personal sphere of influence if we are to eliminate the scourge in all its forms. We must all be role models. We must all speak out. I am well aware that there is criticism of the 16 Days of Activism campaign. There are some who express the opinion that it is only during these days that many organizations around Belize highlight the issue of gender-based violence, although there is a concentrated effort by stakeholders to raise awareness and galvanize action during the campaign. The work is ongoing throughout the year. The Ministry of Human Development, along with its government and civil society partners, are continuously working to holistically address the many facets of gender-based violence. The fact that most of the work is not seen is a consequence of the confidential nature of the matter. The protection of victims must be done with sensitivity and confidentiality, but nonetheless, year-round, there are those working quietly and tirelessly to protect victims, from the police station to the hospital, to the courtroom, to the social worker's office, to the shelter. Efforts to strengthen and coordinate the response to gender-based violence is coordinated through the National Gender-Based Violence Committee, which is a multi-sectoral body comprised of several governmental and non-governmental organizations seeking to respond comprehensively to an issue that goes beyond just mere incidents. 16 Days of Activism campaign is not only a tool to demonstrate solidarity around the world, but an opportunity to provide a forum for organizers to develop and share new and effective strategies. as well as to create tools to pressure government to implement promises made to eliminate gender-based violence. Thus, my call during this year's 16 Days of Activism observance is a challenge to everyone to understand the dynamics of violence and increase our awareness of how we can be more supportive, more open, and more proactive on this issue. It is not enough to only point fingers at those around you and hold accountable only the perceived duty bearers. We must all ask ourselves what role we can play in addressing the many manifestations of violence. We need to be honest with ourselves and determine through self-reflection if we ourselves perpetuate values of discrimination, judgment, ultimately violence. Let's unmask all the faces of violence. Let's all truly unite to end violence in Belize. One step at a time, one person at a time. Thank you.